Alright, what's up guys? Here at Spa, just gonna do a little testing session, a shakedown session. I'm gonna just run the setup from Indy, because it's my most developed setup. I'll grab that. Again, default weather. We'll see what she's like. I did do a little BOP testing here, but that was a while ago now. First things first, just get a little warmed up. Understeer. Serious understeer. That initially just feels like it has a little too much understeer on throttle. But I'm not even close to warmed up yet, so that's just my initial feelings. But it's definitely understeering out of there more than I'd like. Kinda had a feeling I was gonna do that. So I remember in my BOP testing that actually I had to put stiffer springs in it for this truck just so it would go through those corners without getting all weird and feeling like jealous. I might start off by putting stiffer springs in it. It just feels like the car air kind of gives out going through there and loses any form of stability. Unfortunately, that's going to make it less desirable over the curbs. I also need to mess around with the gearing because right now I'm running the taller gears here. Way too much understeer going through there. Again, slow understeer through there. And try and back off a little bit sooner and see if we can go through this corner without getting too crazy. And then next lap I'll be just back off a little bit later and then see if I can find where the limit is. Again, understeer going through there. And getting back on the throttle. Some of the understeer in that corner might just be because of the gearing too, because I'm going right into fourth gear as I go through there and that. Usually when you're that low in the revs in a gear, it'll kind of make the car push a little bit more. That's not horrible. But it's not good either. Rear end still wants to step out. think I might just go with the rear spring increase for the first adjustment. The front felt pretty good through there, although I wasn't really pushing too hard. And I could see where stiffer rear springs would help me with get rid of a little bit of understeer in a couple corners too. Like this one, for example, when I'm getting on the throttle. A stiffer rear end might help with the rotation right here, so I wouldn't have to lift like I did right there. And it might help me a little bit more with the rotation through here as well. And through here. It's not tons of understeer, but it's definitely enough to make you lose time. Kind of gets in a lazy slide through there. Just need that rear end to feel a little more planted. Let's see what happens. Let me just stiffen up the rear end a little bit. First, we need to kind of equalize these tire pressures. So I'm going to go up 2 clicks, 1 click, down 1 click. Let's see what that's like. Then I'm going to go up 2 clicks on the rear springs, but I'm going to make sure this goes back down to 130. Go. Yeah, let's see what it feels like with a little bit stiffer springs in it now. Just in the rear though, so putting those stiffer springs in the rear. Making the rear of the car a little bit stiffer. So when it goes into corners, it's going to have a stiffer roll stiffness. Which, when you make the rear stiffer relative to the front, it should give you more oversteer. And then it also affects the pitch of the car when you get on the gas or when you get on the brakes. It'll transfer the weight to the rear tires a little bit quicker when you get on the gas, and the front's gonna, and it's gonna unload the weight and transfer it a little bit quicker to the front when you get on the brakes, and all that stuff promotes more oversteer in the car. But what I'm afraid of in this car is just putting too much spring over it, and then it becomes kind of a nightmare over the bumps. I still have a lot of testing to do to see if I can just get rid of that with more damper adjustments and make it a little bit better over the bumps with even stiffer dampers. Might need to stiffen up the front a little bit too. Sorry, I just realized my foot cam fell. Yeah, still got some understeer in it, that's for sure. Felt better. I was just a little hesitant to turn as much as I wanted to because I was waiting for it to snap loose, but felt better, so I'll be a little more aggressive with my turning. Again, you don't want to be aggressive with your turning. I was just being very tentative time through there, so next time by, I'll just turn in like I kind of want to. See what the car does. Better through there. Got rid of some of the understeer through there, but still feel like we have too much understeer going through a couple corners on entry. Right there, I'd like a little more rotation in the car. Oh yeah, much better. Much better. Still got work to do, but I was in the right direction for sure. Better through there too. See what our tires are like. There we go, a little bit better balance in them. So, I'm gonna do a little experiment. Well, first, I don't know. I want to change the gears, so I might as well just do two things at the same time. I'm going to go a click up in springs again all around. So, up one click there, up one click here. Make a note that it's 130 and 70 roughly for the ride heights. I'm actually going to let the ride heights increase because they look like they increase pretty evenly there. Maybe go down one click in the front here. I'm going to go down one more click. Just letting the ride heights get a little bit higher. Just messing with that arrow underneath the car, see if this is going to help with getting that rear diffuser a little bit higher off the ground for more stability. Also give me a little bit more travel over the bumps and seeing just if a firmer overall suspension is better suited for this track than a softer one, which I kind of think it is because you have a lot more high speed corners where downforce plays a role. And for downforce, you want a stiffer suspension so it can just take that weight that's pushing down on the wings and transfer it straight into the tires instead of being absorbed by the springs and being a little bit more sluggish. If it was all mechanical grip and the car didn't have wings, then you could go with a little bit softer suspension because a stiffer suspension really wouldn't benefit you much. But I mean, everything's stiff point. If you're too stiff, it's going to be terrible no matter what kind of car you have. If you're too stiff, it's going to be terrible no matter what kind of car you have. So again, you got to find that balance. I'm also hoping with a little bit stiffer front end overall compared to the rear. We didn't really change the balance front to rear, but maybe we got that front to just take advantage of the aero a little bit more through the faster stuff, be a little bit more responsive than it was before. I'll just see how this experiment goes. Still understeering through there. Feels good so far. See what happens when we go through these corners. Pretty aggressive there. Felt pretty good. You just gotta be careful when you're coming up over the crest there. So I was hesitant to get back on the throttle, because with this car not like in the bumps, if you're full throttle, more than likely it's gonna try and buck you off. I really did like the way that felt with the front end through there being a little bit stiffer. Definitely starting to feel a little bit more like a race car. I think with Indy, it was just so many low-speed corners that going back to that softer suspension for mechanical grip, which you're going to need more mechanical grip in the slow-speed stuff because obviously you're not going to be going fast enough to take care of the arrow. I think that's why you're seeing the difference in the what you need for spring. It's in the two different tracks because they're pretty much polar opposites. When you're talking about the types of corners and how fast you're going through them. I turned in a little bit too early there. Also feels more stable going through the, interesting enough, feels more stable going, coming out of the exit of that last little chicane right there. And feels really good going through there too. Which even those corners, they're slow speed, but not quite as slow as some of the corners at Indy. Car feels pretty good until I get to just before the crest and it starts unloading at its weight. It starts getting a little sketchy right there, so I'll probably have to do some damper work to. Figure that out. Might even try another click stiffer springs and see how it feels. I think I'm gonna, just going to have to go through Outrage without lifting and seeing what the car does. Well, I mean, I'm going to lift, but not be so tentative and just see what the car actually does. I can sense it's going to do something, but I don't exactly know what it's going to do. Let's see what it does this lap. 21.5. All right, Godspeed. All right, so the rear end stepped out on me on entry. I kind of turned in just like I'd want to turn in. So I think I'll make a little damper adjustment. That's the way I want to be able to turn into the corner, but the rear end wasn't having it, so. Let's see what we got here. Put some. And put two clicks of low speed rebound dampening in it. So as we're going through the corner. Going in through the corner right about here. So right here, as I'm turning into the corner, going on to the right, the low speed rebound dampening, what I adjusted, this right here on the back, it controls these springs as they release from compression. So the idea here being is I put more dampening in it, so that means it's gonna control this spring as it releases from compression at a slower rate by putting more dampening in it. You put less dampening in it, it's gonna let the spring release from compression quicker. So as I'm turning into the corner and the car is turning to the right, this inside is gonna want to lift up. Well, I'm slowing that down now, so hopefully it will transfer the weight to this tire slower. Just trying to slow down the rate at which the weight transfers in the rear end. Right now it's just a little too responsive back there, causing it to want to kick loose. That's what's so tricky about this track, is you can, if it was just all these types of corners, it wouldn't be a hard track to set up for at all. But the fact that you gotta go through radio on Al Rouge completely throws a wrench in the mix and makes this track probably one of the harder tracks to set up for. Because you're in sixth gear going through that corner. I mean, you're pretty much going flat out through there, and it's just so different than all these other corners. Even this corner is really, unless you're driving the McLaren, there's really nothing to that once you get a car set up for it. But radio outreach are just, really make you do things this setup you wouldn't do normally for all these other types of corners. So it's always a tricky track to set up for. You know, you can always just drive through these corners slower, but ultimately you want to be able to drive around this whole track comfortable and as fast as you can while doing it comfortably. Seems still kind of being tentative because I'm waiting for it to, I'm almost counter steering before it's sliding, because that's what I'm expecting it to do. So each lap I'll try and just keep pushing it a little bit more. I think it's best if you stay off that curb on that right-hander. And you don't want to touch this curb, but you want to get as close to it as you can. Kind of pushed out too wide there. Again, I still need to experiment with the gears. That corner just carried too much speed into. Honestly, the car feels really good in the second half of the lap. still a little bit of understeering couple because I need to get rid of, but I can lean on it a lot, and I really like when I can lean on a car. Just instills confidence. Not really second guessing the car at all, you're just driving it. That felt pretty doggone good. But like I was talking about earlier, it gets a little sketchy coming up over that crest, but we're doing better on entry now. I honestly think coming over that crest, like, I'll experiment more with the dampers, but I think that's just gonna have to be something I have to drive through with this car. Or figure out the damper settings and get lucky and find a magical setting or something like that. Maybe mess with the high-speed dampers and just see if we can find a setting that works. A little bit better line there, but still a little too much understeer. Might have to mess with the rake of the car, lower the front a little bit more. Thinking I want to experiment more with ride heights like I did at Indy here. I think it's going to be a little more telling at this track, experiment with ride heights, what it does for aero, because it's more high-speed corners where aero influences the car more, so move the car up overall and down overall and see what it likes. Oh, pretty good, because I took that way far inside, and there's a little bump on the inside there. It usually upsets the car, but this went through there pretty nice. Yeah, rear end, I kind of jerked at the wheel when I initially turned in, so the rear end wanted to step out of me. What was important about that is when I can get the proper inside line and get the car a little bit straighter over that hump, I can get on the throttle sooner, so a lot of this is just going to be working on my timing and my line through there. Just being able to get the car in a good position so I can get on the throttle early. There we go. I just think what I need to work on now is getting that front end to turn a little bit more. Because I don't want to have to lift more than I did there. If I would have lifted more, I could have got the front end to turn more. But I want to be able to just crack the throttle, like, that slight amount and get the front end to turn a little bit more. So that again, going in the right direction. Those front tires are getting a little bit higher impression. We really aren't doing a lot of laps yet. But for now, I'll just leave them there. So, we'll go one more click on the low speed rebound dampening. Same thing as we did last time. And we'll go one click less on the compression dampening. So, it's doing the same, we're going the same direction as, we're kind of doing the same thing we were doing with the compression dampening in the last adjustment. We're just doing it in a different way. So, with the compression dampening, we're controlling the springs as they release from compression. Or, with the rebound dampening, sorry, we're controlling the springs as they rebound from their compression. With the compression dampening that I did here, I put, I went from 34... to 35, so that takes a little bit of more dampening out of those dampers. So with compression, it controls the rate at which the springs compress. So as we're going into this corner, we're turning to the right, the car's rolling to its left, it's compressing on the left side. We're now allowing, there's less dampening in here, right? So I always like to talk about this in extremes because it's the easiest way for me to visualize it. So if you had full dampening on this side, your spring basically wouldn't be compressing. I mean, it will be, but it's going to be doing it at a lot slower rate. So what happens, instead of all this weight that's on this tire going into the spring as it's compressing, now that the spring's not really compressing anymore, or compressing at a slower rate, it just goes directly into the tire. So this weight transfers from here to here quicker because it's more of a solid rear end. When you take the dampening out of the compression, you're allowing the spring to do more work, and it actually transfers the weight at a slower rate, even though the spring's technically allowed to compress faster. The weight from this tire is now going through the compression of that spring, albeit we just took one click out, so it's just a little bit faster on its compression, but again, it's spending energy during that time compressing that little bit more or a little bit quicker instead of going directly into the tire. So long story short, when you increase rebound or decrease compression, you're creating slower transfer of weight from one tire to the other. Now at the front, I want to speed up the transfer of weight. So I want the front tires. I'm doing the opposite of what I'm doing in the rear. Now, when I'm going into this corner, I want the front to be more responsive. So, as it's going into the corner this way, I want the weight to transfer over to this tire quicker. So, in order to do that, because if you have a more responsive front end, it's going to want to turn in more. So, in order to do that, we go opposite of what we just did. So I'm going to increase the high-speed compression one click, increase the low-speed compression one click, the high-speed compression one click. Low speed is more for the handling of the car. Compression's more for bumps, but high speed also does control the bumps as well, or the handling of the car as well. And then with the rebound, we want things to happen faster, so we kind of want to free up those springs as they're compressing, they're releasing from compression, so it can transfer the weight quicker. So it, you almost think of it like a tie down. You have more rebound, it's going to tie this end down, and it's going to take longer for the weight to transfer over there. So we want to free that up. In order to free that up, you put less rebound dampening in it. So what we're going to do, I'm also going to lower the front one click. And this will increase the rake of the car. So now the front's going to be just, what is it? Half a millimeter lower, not even that, just like a quarter of a millimeter lower in the front. So it actually creates a lower center of gravity here. It moves the center of gravity more forward. It's going to put more weight on the front tires. The front end's going to be more responsive. It's not going to have as much roll in it, but it's going to allow the weight to transfer a little bit quicker. Just basically, when you lower the front of the car relative to the rear, it's going to create more overall oversteer. So, let's see what we got. Ultimately, what I'm trying to do is just to get the car to have a more natural flow around the track, just be more in sync with the track. So I'm not understeering into the corner, having to put more wheel into it, so when I get on the gas, I want to snap oversteer. I'm just trying to make the car be more in sync with the flow of the track. Still a little sketchy. My line's not the best through there right now. It gets a little sketchy. Coming up over the crest, I'm offline and I have to put more wheel in it. Again, I think it's a lot of me, the driver, just really needing to get the right line through there. Do you like the way the car's turning into the corners? Probably shouldn't have gone to second gear there. It's turning better through that corner. Yeah, still need a little bit more rotation through there. Pretty big improvement on lap time, though. See if I can get a little bit better line through here. Just right now, I'm doing too much count. I don't have confidence in the car making my initial turn in. So I think what I might do is increase the spring rates all around again. Still feels like it's getting a little weird on initial turn in. You feel like the car goes through there better in third gear now. Before, I had to go down to second gear to help it to turn, but seems like I can keep it in third gear through there. And it's definitely better on throttle through here. Better on throttle through there once I get the right turning point. Feels pretty good. I'm gonna save that because it's an improvement, but let's see what stiffer springs do. So I'm trying to keep it at 70 and then 131. Low 131s when we go up one more click on the springs all around. Whoa, looks like we already maxed out rear springs. Alright. So let's just see what happens when we put stiffer springs in the front. Since we can't put stiffer springs in the rear, so it should change the balance a little bit. Put a little more understeer into the car. So I'm actually going to go down to, instead of being at like 70.1, it'll be a little bit lower, 69.8. So again, we're changing that rake, which I'm kind of anticipating the car having more understeer now, with just increasing front springs and not doing the rear springs because you're increasing that front stiffness, which will cause more understeer. So to anticipate that, I'm lowering the front of the car just a little bit more. See if that cancels out the difference. See if we got a car we can really lean on through Rio de la Rouge. I'll probably wait till I get in public sessions to experiment with the gearing, just to see how the car is in the draft. Hopefully this feels a lot better through Rio de la Rouge, and then I can just run a couple more laps and then call it for this video. It feels awesome through there right now, but we're on brand new tires, so I just gotta keep that in mind. Oh, good. It's just pushing through the middle, going up the hill. Let's see if I can work on my line a little bit more. Try and get a little bit later apex on the right-hander going uphill. I really like the way it got through the second part of that corner. Front end felt like it had good bite in it. It's got good turn in through there. A little bit understeer going through there. That's probably because I was carrying more speed through that first corner than I ever had been before. Got pretty good rotation through there. Yeah, I missed my turning. Okay, I just had to be a little bit more patient with my turn in.
on.
Still trying to figure out exactly what the car is doing through there. Like, there, it just kind of turned in like I wanted to, and instead of it snapping out, it kind of just went into a four-wheel slide, which is much more desirable characteristic if you're gonna... The car's gonna start doing what you don't want it to do. You'd much rather just do a four-wheel slide than snap loose, because then it's a lot easier to just lift the throttle, wait for all four tires to hook back up and go on your way. It feels pretty good through there. Maybe just go through it in a more reasonable fashion without trying to attack it too hard. Accidentally went to third gear there. Thank you. There you go. That was pretty aggressive through there and did quite nicely. Right now for me the car's a little bit on the understeer side. I think it's a decent set put out there for a baseline. Rather have it be on the understeer side than the oversteer side. It's just a lot easier to manage a car with understeer. Couple things you can do: soften up the front roll bar, lower the front ride height, but I wouldn't really recommend doing it more than a click or two. Put a little bit more compression dampening in it, take a little more rebound dampening out of it. Experiment with the differential. Maybe take a click of diff out of it. That'll help turn in on entry. Couple things you can do if you want to experiment. If you want to get crazy, take the rest of the wing out, because right now it's running a B wing. But I'm gonna call it for this session. See where the tire pressures are at real quick. Probably start thinking about going down a click on the tire pressures, bring it to 172 all around. But leave that for another session. I imagine this weather we have here is going to be a little bit warmer than anything we'll see in the public sessions. So, car might actually feel even a little bit better in that stuff, and then be able to put a little bit more rotation in it without worrying about it getting loose on us. So, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you next time.